Hi, good afternoon everyone, and thank you team for introducing me so well. That's the most amazing introduction of mine that I have ever heard. An audience, I have some questions for you. Do you believe intelligence and success can be connected together somehow? Okay, do you know what an IQ means? All of us think and believe that we know, but do we really understand that? Does IQ reveal more than just how intelligent we are, or sometimes we want us to be? And then, does it affect our lives? And to focus more on a point, I would like to ask you, does it affect our success? Do you believe a girl who always stood first when you were back in school had the highest IQ? If she had, where she is now? Is she still doing the best? Now let me tell you a story of a man with an IQ of 210, which is the highest IQ score ever recorded. He is Kim Yoon-yong, a South Korean professor who has a mention in Guinness World Record of the highest IQ. And he himself criticized this idea and said, "Some people think that with a high IQ you can become omnipotent, but that's not true. Look at me, I don't have a musical talent, nor am I excelling in these sports? But yes, if you can connect intelligence and success together, Kim's name must be replaced by yours. And let me tell you, what do I think? IQ is a measure of general intelligence, but it does not affect our success. Success is not directly proportional to one's intelligence. It is an outcome of its attitude and imagination. Some of you only dreams, but not have the right attitude to make that happen. Success follows when you are able to absorb the chaos happening in your surroundings, when you know how to respond to odd circumstances, when you are flexible to adapt new things, when you take right decision at the right time, when you are able to handle your emotions, when you start learning from your failures, when you don't miss any opportunity, and the most important, when you stop blaming your background, because it doesn't really matter where do you come from, but where you are going is all that matters. And you yourself can witness that everyone you believe is successful in his life does not necessarily belong to a kingdom. You can also name some very easily. And did you ever realize the people, the stories, or sometime a movie or a web series affect you the most if you can connect with the character? If you have experienced something they share. Now why it happens so? Because you see yourself at their place. But the only difference between these two species is one only dreams and the other one strives. We people have a tendency to make us believe that it was our destiny. No, it wasn't. We chose it because we did this much. We dream to go to the moon, but remain indulged in other things. Things which are making our present pleasant. We focus more on our short-term assignments, our current job, our current situation, our current financial crisis, and try to manage everything every day and every moment, while ignoring our vision. We set boundaries without giving it a thought. What does it really mean? And many times, these self-declared boundaries hold us back. These boundaries does not let us dream, fly, and aspire. I believe boundaries are important. But can we do it little wisely? Can we set it to draw a clear line between what is visible for us and what is not? You need to figure out what is achievable. You need to figure out what drives you to do your best. I know I am best when I have a tight schedule, tough deadlines, or I can say that I love facing challenges. Challenges are what making our victory more pleasant. When I joined my first job after college, I was also preparing for engineering services also. Here I had to deal with my fierce ambition, my boss expectation, the learning curve, the future insecurities, and a reputed organization work culture which I wasn't familiar with. Still, when I used to go back and look at the pile of the books after a long tiring day, I had a sudden brainwave which hits me every time. That says, it's tough. But I say to myself, let's do this. I would say my upbringing made me diligent and strong. One thing which I want to share is that I love the most about my father is he always let me do whatever I asked him. He let me take decisions on my own. I still remember when I was young, I used to ask my father, I'm stuck here. What should I do now? He never gave me a solution. Rather, he asked me 3-4 more questions and always asked me to do whatever felt right to me. And doing this, he let me live my dreams. Here I would really love to mention this conference wonderful theme. Imagine, invent, inspire. Before starting anything, we have to imagine, learn, and find ways to convert that imagination into reality so that we can do something so great that can inspire others. Everyone whom you see as a successful person once made a right decision what was courageous enough to walk on a different path. Guys, everyone has a story to tell. Everyone has gone through something that has changed them. Every one of us have a life-inspiring story of others. Some incidents are worth sharing with the world, but how many of us were fortunate enough to do it? Very few of us, right? And this fortune comes to those who are keen to know more, to do more, and to strive more, to walk an extra mile. Success follows when you keep moving, when you don't feel settled. Lately, I received a picture from one of my students. It was a cover page of a monthly magazine that we used to follow for general science questions. And trust me, it won't be a metaphor to say that I literally jumped upon my chair. I was featured on that cover page. In a corner though, if I had felt settled after becoming an IAS officer, I would have never get a chance to be on that cover page or to be here in front of you sharing my experiences like this. Now, can we take another dimension for this? As I just told that a man who has highest IQ cannot be omnipotent, but an intelligent person can find out that one thing he is good at and can improve on that to be better and then the best. He can move strategically. I want to share a real story with you. I had a friend who qualified UPSC examination. He chose economics as an optional subject and scored the highest marks in economics as well, but could not make it because the other fellows who had opted another subject scored more than him, and he had to settle at PCS grade only. Let's figure out what was wrong in his story. He had a brilliant mind, he had dreams, he had a clear vision, and was very much passionate about it. He had everything in abundance, what we have discussed till now. But he was not a good decision maker. Right decision at right time are as much important as anything in the whole universe. At the end, let's connect the anecdotes. To do something really great, you need to be courageous. To do something really great, you need to be courageous enough to dream. Intelligent enough to figure out if your dreams are achievable. And wise enough to take the right decision at right time. And the world will see you succeeding. Thank you.